knight with his banners all bravely.
As assistant director of Man of La Mancha, I do a good amount of things. You know, I had to block a number and a scene that goes into that number. So I blocked the dubbing into the Knight of the Woeful Countenance with Alex's help, obviously. I help out Alex with whatever he needs, and he helps me because it's a learning experience. It's really cool. And it's really weird being on the other side of things, because like I've been an actor in all of these shows for such a long time, but now seeing like everything that gets put into it, and you know, like yelling at the people for talking and stuff like that when I was the one talking, it's just really interesting, but it's super fun.
I'm Sancho, I'll follow my...
Part of my job as stage manager is to take blocking notes. So they look a little something like this. We have diagrams on this side and script notes on this side. So we have like Rachel exits stage right, for example. Then once we get closer to the show, I'm the one who's calling the cues, which means I'm the one who makes the lights go, all the sounds play, things flying up and down, and I am overseeing a lot of things. My role as production manager is basically to make sure that all of tech runs smoothly and just work with all the crew heads and check their goals and everything, and I'm basically like the stage manager of tech.
For me, the production process starts by reading the script and looking at some of the concrete details, such as the time and the setting of the piece, and then looking at some of the more abstract details, such as the themes and the character arcs, so that the set and the characters can interact with one another instead of being beside one another for the show.
And then my job is like looking at a drawing or a model of the final set, and I'll look at the individual pieces, all the set pieces, see what color and what texture they are, and then put that together on the real set. And then it's mostly just painting wood to look like other wood. So.
Okay, so for this show we used warmer tones and brighter lights for the La Mancha world, but for the prison world we used cooler tones and dimmer lighting until at the end when they all started to meld together, and here is our plot.
This show is set in 1600 Spain and in the prison, so for this sound effect we have is just showing when the captain of the Inquisition, or the Inquisition in general, is coming in to check up on the prisoners. That boom was to show the doors opening. And then this is just showing how the prison doors are opening up and transitioning.
It's all the same.
So these are our horse and mule head, and this is our lance for the show. They're all meant to look like found objects, so this one's supposed to look like a branch, and these two are, you know, they're made of burlap and buttons and mop. So they're supposed to look really like just kind of like someone could just throw them together, which is kind of the point of the show.
Same thing with all the other props. They look like found objects that these prisoners have just like had for a while or did they
collected over time.
Yep.
Just put your mind.
I'm the lead costume designer, and here are my renderings for this show. I made it so people related to Don Quixote are in warm tones, and characters like Carrasco and Antonia, who are like opposites, are in colder tones, like dark colors. This is an example of what we're making. This is Aldonza's skirt. Her main color is red. All the frills are like in different shades of red. It's supposed to be like kind of patchworky, and then it's like influenced off of flamenco dresses. And this is obviously in progress.
Okay, I'm Helen. I'm the associate costume designer, and I designed all the other people who are dancing around. I try to make them all look very found, very old, because they've been in the prison for a long time, and all of them are tried to be historical, and they're all made to move and to be like simple, but add to the building of the world so that when you watch, everything looks like it's supposed to be a part of it.
As dance captain, I'm in charge of learning all the dancing numbers and choreography. People can come to me asking for guidance, questions, yeah.
I am me, I am Aldonza.
We start with the read-through, and then after about 6 weeks, we are ready to move into our theater and join forces with our tech department.
Part of the rehearsal process is blocking. So Alex will give us blocking or movement to do on the stage. We'll run through it a few times, make sure we got it. From there, we'll apply our characters to the blocking, and it just makes the show come more alive.
A big part of the process is going through the script and really understanding who you are, your backstory, why you're doing what you're doing, and then take a breath, enter the rehearsal space, and immediately flip a switch and just be who you are in the show and have fun with it.
Come